The state government has handpicked a selection of apartment designs and will fast-track their development in the latest attempt to tackle Melbourne's housing shortage. But the move has some real estate experts wondering whether anyone will want to live there.
Day 8 of the state government's plan to woo younger voters, a housing pitch with a big price tag.
We want to see more diversity in the types of homes that are being built.
These are the types of properties the Allan government wants to see more of, and they're cutting the red tape to do it, slashing approval wait times for townhouses and low-rise apartments they consider well-designed from 12 months to 4.
For buildings that are innovative, that are sustainable, that look good.
They're not unlocking projects that would be feasible today that would deliver more homes for more people.
We've seen a rush of announcements in the last week simply to try to pretend that there's real action being undertaken.
The idea is modelled on boutique, high-quality apartment builds like this one in South Melbourne.
We need more projects like this to showcase that it's a great way to live for a family.
With award-winning design on the doorstep of the CBD, the apartments don't come cheap. A one-bedroom will set you back up to $650,000, a two-bedroom around $950,000, for three beds a minimum of $1.2 million.
There are questions about who wants to live in the mid-level apartment buildings the government is promising. A recent survey showed just one in five would consider the move from the suburbs, and only if the price was comparable.
The price point you have to now sell them for to make them attainable and feasible for a developer is very, very high.
Rochelle Brown, 7 News.